Good afternoon, everyone. Well, this survey was nationwide. They took a look at more than 181,000 survey respondents at more than 33 campuses across the country, including here at USC. Nationally, they say that every one in four college students says that they've experienced some sort of forcible sexual assault, something that is non-consensual. But here at the USC campus, those numbers are slightly higher. It's estimated that every one in three undergrad students here at this campus have experienced some sort of sexual assault. And not only did they look at the prevalence, they also looked at the perception of sexual assault as well as the reporting. Now, here on the campus of USC, this study revealed that there's been about a 3% increase in reporting. But one of the troubling statistics is how many people felt confident that their reports would be taken seriously. Nationwide, that's about 53%, but here on the campus, it's only in the high 30 percentile. Again, that's something that the university believes that they do need to work on. Now, again, this was a wide-ranging study. They hadn't done anything like this since 2015. It was actually conducted by the American Association of Colleges and Universities. In California, USC took part, as well as Stanford and Caltech. And again, the numbers are very discouraging considering the Me Too movement and all that has been done to try to get the word out about sexual assault and how to prevent them. Now, most of the people that did participate in the survey that said that they were victims of sexual assault also said that they were non-consenting in large part because they were unable to, whether that was because they were asleep or by force or because they were perhaps inebriated by drugs or alcohol. And speaking of drugs and alcohol, we spoke to a number of students here on campus today. Many of them were quite candid about the culture and the climate, which they say could contribute to these sort of sexual assaults.
I think definitely USC has a big problem with people getting roofied. That's a huge thing, big common theme here, but yeah, I think that could be a big reason. And like, I mean, the frat culture is like super huge and that like gets to people's heads.
I would imagine, especially on a campus where the fraternity life and sorority life is such a big part of the culture and a lot of the kids here are legacy children, I can imagine why reporting goes under the radar for a lot of people here.
Now, USC is trying to do their part to be as proactive as possible. They knew these results were coming out today, so they issued this statement campus-wide. This is just a portion of it, and it says, quote, "The survey results clearly show the need for ongoing work to strengthen the prevention and the intervention efforts already underway and to provide additional support for those impacted. We value your input and will continue to work diligently to improve the climate on our campuses." And speaking of that, they have held already one town hall meeting today. That wrapped up within the last hour. They have another town hall meeting for 4:30 here on campus today. They're encouraging anyone here on campus to come and share their thoughts, their concerns. And the campus says that they're also putting together a task force from the provost's office to further investigate what can be done to make more undergraduates, more students, feel safe. That's the very latest here at the campus of USC. I'm Wendy Burch, and I'll send it back to you.